Hi guys, this is Emnal, and we are back playing as Soviet Union, Pathfinder 4 and such. Let's continue. Seems like our units are getting ready to do some attacks around here. Perhaps we can get ourselves a small packet around here if we are so inclined. Okay, let's take half of those units and move them there. You and well, most should probably go to Vladivostok, I imagine. And where are they going? There, okay. Let's do the redeployment instead of standard movement, and we're good. Here, however, we won't be able to punch through, I don't think. Oh shit, yeah, definitely not. Let's see, can we even hold this? Not really. A 50 attack per. Well, good thing is that they're kind of limited to. Well, we'll be able to hold it for a while, but yeah, that's about it. What should we do? So we can definitely punch through just a little. Well. Should be able to punch through to some extent here, but I think it was a mistake to deploy here. Now when I look about it, at it, we should have deployed here and reinforced our potential breakthrough. I didn't really expect them to throw 50 divisions here. That's right. I know it's 40, but yeah, well, there's probably quite a few running around somewhere. We do have a few more coming, but that's in how long? Well, almost a month. That's bad. I think that's the problem. Even if we punch through here, we don't have enough to. To hold it. I guess we can take those divisions. They should be able to hold more or less. So let's grab a handful and throw them in here. One thing that it doesn't seem like they are actually attacking here, and even if we sacrifice a few divisions here and there, not a big deal. So let's take 17 and we should be good. Yeah, and here it's even if they manage to push through, it will take ages, and so this whole thing will end sooner or later. Now I think we go this way. Okay, what is the fastest route? This is fastest route. There's also a decent one in such a way that it would give us a river on one side. It's how many? Three forest provinces. Good enough. Okay, let's try to do that. We'll have to take away some of those divisions, of course, to do the make it a bit wider and such, so that's about it. Definitely want to be on the defensive here, and definitely want more divisions to do that. And yeah, also here, defense. Yeah, so all of that and all of what was steamrolling us through here got quickly redirected to this front, which is surprisingly competent of AI. They sure managed to realize which attack out of all of those on the whole huge front is the most dangerous one. So actually quite impressive, isn't it? It's speaking of impressive attacks. Alright, so we are not going to continue here, but we should be able to hold this. Right? Yeah. Okay. Let's grab this just to be sure. Let's move actually this way. Right, might as well. We do actually... Okay, so this is the same state, so our mere presence here is enough to help with... what's it, with resistance, that was the word I was looking for. And we got ourselves quite a few dockyards and two factories, which is always nice. Especially since they were mostly free. Dangerous naval invasion in Siberia, really? I don't care. I don't think that there is the possibility of a dangerous invasion in Siberia. I don't think we don't we even have a bloody port there, so yeah. I'm looking forward to it if that's going to happen. Okay, so here we'll allow our units to regain some strength. Why are you guys so slow, by the way? Oh, right. We do have an enemy does have air spirit here. Have you gotten? That's the problem. We don't have any airfields in range. We do have air spirit in the Russian Far East, which is nice, I guess, but. If we were on the defensive. Okay, range. Where is it? Oh, so this one, I can... Isn't this one better in one battle? Really? Oh, alright, allied bases. Alright, so let's get ourselves... like we do not have fire. Okay, I think we need to redeploy some fighters. Perhaps move some from here. That would be faster, I think. So, let's see. Distance, let's take 600 from here and throw them into Mongolia. And yeah, that will be basically that's still too far. We need to capture. An airfield first, or build one. Problem is that we can't really build on airfields in Mongolia. Okay, actually, let's ask for control of a state. I want to control all those states. Should be enough to for them to give it to me, right? I should have asked for only for one. Okay, should actually okay, you need to strategically deploy. You're also moving here, so strategic redeployment it is. You should actually attack here and try to get a line between those two. Yeah. Okay, how is this? Yeah, we should actually move in here. I know we have no organization, but neither do they. That should be good enough, and you guys aren't actually deploying, are you? Which is absurd. Okay, let's take all of people that are moving here. Okay, you aren't deploying either. Yeah, I actually want this to be limited to this one. Yeah, they move like 15 divisions. This is not going to be easy. Yeah. Good thing I'm moving the rest of my panzers here, that should be enough at some point. This is fairly, seems fairly safe. Okay, this nonsense. Right. Okay, so this is actually not that Can we pull it off? I'm actually very skeptical. Okay, Okay, so this is a problem because it seems like I cannot extend my front line to here, despite the fact that this is, you know, I think we need to pull out. Yeah, that's basically too many of them. And that's what was it? Right, so let's remove this and just get them here till the. Till they recapture this one, because this is just way too many. We can't hold both this and get yeah. Basically, we'd have to hold this, this, and this, and that's impossible with just 5 divisions. And I don't think we can spare any more from here. I could try, but all right. Let's focus on this whole mess. We could move some fighters from here, but it's kind of pointless because we don't have... it's not that we don't have enough fighters, it's that we don't have enough range. Well, we don't... we hardly have range to cover Mongolia itself. Let alone whatever it is here. I guess moving or just running around pointlessly, or a little bit of both, I guess. Go there. There we go. Well, I do realize I'm throwing too many divisions here, and I guess I should try to do it wider. Right, assembly line production. So as I said, either construction or tanks. I guess we'll go for the tanks. It will take a while, but it will also take a while to build up and, enough of them. So let's just go for it. If we can either go for them or now or not at all, because and seems like we are in a maybe not a winning spot, but fairly safe one. So might as well invest in something that will be beneficial to us in the long run. The same reason why I'm not investing in infantry tech that would support us now, since we are kind of holding. And nationalist China, nationalist Spain joined the Axis, as expected. Now, let's try to. Actually, I'll just order the attack here. Frankly, we should actually order the other attack here as well. They definitely pulled out a lot of that, so we might as well start widening. This down. Okay. Now. Yeah. Need to select before we can go. This one, not yet. They need to arrive and. Imagine we are struggling with supplies in several points. Yeah, mostly here. It would be good at some. Shortly. We don't need more planes operating just yet, so this is good. We should, however, add the Vilno. Let's try adding more close air support if we do have some. Once again, set it to 100. Haven't I had them here? Could have. Okay. Okay, I'm confused. What have I done? okay, once again. That limit, and yes, that's what I wanted. And here we go. That should help. We may even finally get some bloody air experience too. Would be a nice change of pace. Are we getting any airfields here? Because I have no doubt that if we were able to actually send some planes here, that was fast, we would easily win the air war, but, well, that's the problem. Wow, that's not going very well, is it? One enemy divisions can pierce us, okay. It's like even Chinese are getting tanks that can pierce us. that's problematic. Could probably send those few divisions there while they will continue here, more or less. And half of those divisions here to widen the gap. That should do it. Okay, we need to continue this attack though. Where are those? Here. And even half of you. That should do it. Panzers, go through here, rest of you. Yeah, we'll need to keep an eye on that whole situation. Of course, the problem is lack of supplies. Not much we can do about it, really. We just need to push through it. And I guess if we were to get another edge province, which is this one. Okay, so we can get this province. Not now, though. You guys can do it. Here we go. This whole attack. Once again, problems with supply. We've sent too many. Frankly, let's grab a few. And send them there. There we go. Just send them out of this zone. That should more or less help it. Yeah. We are really on the edge. One of the next things that we'll need to research is the next level of logistics company. Especially if we desire to actually use some high-level tanks, because yeah, that will be a massive supply hog. Continue the land grab before we get pushed back. Another thing is that AI isn't as stupid as it's, people claim it, or I claim it to be, because as you can see here, for example, they only send like one division per province or something, rather than 20 per province like in those important provinces. Alright, let's see how that goes. I guess it won't go very well since this attack got stopped. I'm sure you ran out of organization and I wasn't watching, but yeah. Now let's make it a bit smaller. Half of you can attack there. Half of you can deploy here and continue in this direction. How is this going? I guess poorly. And, what's this nonsense? Like they control it. Why there is a? Okay, let's. So weird. Game, don't break on me. Okay, can we even defend this? Yeah, since we're like, we are killing them pretty well. But our low organization makes it look like we're losing, but that's mostly because they suddenly decided to regroup somewhere to China or something due to that front line disappearing. It's always a mess. Okay, not much in terms of attack here. Most of them are getting pushed back rapidly. We may actually want to. Okay, we are probably. Yeah, we are in a very dangerous state as far as infantry equipment goes, as you can see here, but so if we had some surplus in that department, we are starting to work a new line here. It's not yet fully online, but I'm afraid we'll need to add add more. We're also adding support equipment, as you can see, which we are in even bigger need of. The fact that we just finished both industrial techs is helpful, but yeah, we don't have enough of industry to actually try to grind them down here, because we would. Attrition of this fighting would hit us as well, and I'd rather expand our resources in China for the time being. Since I don't think, well, we could probably do some do more damage to them than they would do to us, but it wouldn't last long. And well, since we are playing on max sliders, we need to take into account that AI has stronger industry than we do. Alright, so, well, we are kind of pushing through here, and let's see. Okay, so we actually didn't manage to, this got stopped. Okay, we'll wait for them to regain some organization and try again. Yeah, let's do it. I definitely want you guys here. And this attack, yeah. Good enough. So I don't want. What I basically don't want is one line corridor. Well, try to start a one line corridor, because it will be very difficult to push through with 12 division defending and us being able to only throw 3 at them. So I try to wiggle my way through by attacking into a few directions, even if some or, well, many of those attacks won't work. Okay, we've managed to push through here. That should help with our supply situation. Not exactly. And we need actually to capture this one too. Actually, we basically need to capture all those three here. So let's actually use those units to do just that. Okay, one here. You guys that are moving here, how about we go and attack this? Here it's like, it's enough that you guys hold the line, you don't need to push through it, or at least put some pressure, do an impression of danger and such. Expeditionary force, no thank you, I'd rather stick to my own units. Yeah, huh. Oh, we actually got pushed out of there. This is shameful. You know what? You can stay. You will try to push out of there. Oh, and now we can actually. It's problematic because I only one of you. All of you move there and try to attack. We'll see how that goes. They sure are attacking a lot, but really getting pushed back fast. Just weird. Those attacks, like before, like from the previous recording session, like 2 weeks ago, those attacks were much more vicious. Not sure what changed. Can remember I had to throw in tongues here and there to plug the gaps, and now I'm not even watching and it seems to be more or less working. Okay, so this attack obviously won't work, but this one will. Actually, those two should. As you can see, only two divisions here, one division here, and in a pretty bad shape. I guess we can push into there as well, because we'll of course run into another problem here, but we are getting into a new supply zone, and we'll need to make sure that our border with the previous one will be wide enough to support what we have, because it already isn't. And we barely thrown in just a few divisions, and to hold it, well, we'll need much more. It seems like we managed to push out units out of here, which was our primary goal. And apparently the whole defense got a bit weaker here. Well, I guess they still have 16 divisions here, but it seems like some of them got moved back to around here, which of course will stop our cavalry charge, but yeah, be expected. How is this going? Slowly, I guess, but yeah, we aren't suffering a lot of attrition since it's June. Okay, so we are about to finish another, 9 divisions. I think we should throw them here. Kinda have enough for the time being. Not really enough, but as much as we can support. Supply-wise. Maybe we should throw some here to start putting pressure on China, on Communist China here. Another thing is, when do we want to declare war on allies? I think very shortly. Okay, this is interesting. They actually landed here and taken bits of Siberia. Interesting. We could throw some units in this. Okay, so this actually got quite scary. Let's pull back. We should probably throw some units there. Here, I believe we do. No, we never really gotten around to building the forts. Yeah, that. Basically, what I'm afraid here is that. If our troops will be here, they will get cut off and destroyed. And if that won't happen, we should be able to hold those straits well enough against what they can throw at us. So, for the time being, I will allow them to regain this province, so we can finally get the proper front line going. Because front lines around straits are very aren't always working, basically. Or I cannot into UI or something, but who knows. Okay, those divisions haven't been deployed in Vladivostok yet, so I guess we will add them to this thing. Okay, first of all, you guys can be here. That should be far enough for them to actually surgically redeploy, maybe. And sign you to this order. Huh. We already have more tanks here, but okay, let's actually just send them here. I think we can survive a few days of lack of supplies. How are the supplies? Actually, we are almost good. Well, of course, we won't be almost good as soon as those tanks arrive, but it should get better when we capture this province, if I more or less know what I'm doing. And this attack, yeah, that should go well enough on its own. And one of you can actually go here and check how many are there. Only one, good. That attack should also help. And are you defending? That's interesting. Okay, one of you, however, can go and help there. That should be always good. And well, for now, the three of you go there. They are assigned to do this province, so they will eventually move there, but for the time being I wanted them to capture the rest of this. Now, we don't have anything covering this. We shouldn't have. That's got bigger without my permission. Let's see, is anything moving there? Nothing is moving there very well. This whole attack should take a while. Alright, we got breakthrough priority. Some breakthrough and organization for both tanks and infantry. So that was the important one, and we got a very good tactic out of it. This one is less important, because it's sure it adds some, that's recovery rate for tanks would be really nice right about now. Alright, that's what, 80 days? I might as well wrap this one up. That of course means that it will be a while till we have more research to go. So because instead of that, I could go for construction or for excavation. But I think we'll actually try to get some use out of our tanks and just wrap up the whole. Are you guys redeploying? You are. And wrap up the whole doctrine thing once and for all. And since we have that research bonus, might as well do it already. Since we are not really investing in things that are useful for us in the short run when it comes to other of our research, so well, one won't hurt. Now, we are out of time, so I'd like to thank you for watching, and I wish to see you next time. Cheers.